Hi everyone, this is Gleeza, Made with Glee. I know I've been slacking with these videos. I'm not making YouTube videos just because I'm not in the mood. I've honestly been spending time in my garden and making masks. I've been making lots and lots of masks for all of my family and a few of my friends, my aunts and cousins. They work in the healthcare industry with the elderly, and they need to be wearing masks all the time. And as you guys know, there is a shortage of face masks. So they need to extend the life of the mask that they have. And these fabric masks that I make, they're washable, of course, but the style that I've used to make these masks allow the user to extend the life of an actual surgical mask or N95 mask by just sticking it inside. Now, this is not a full tutorial. If you have any questions about how exactly I make my mask, feel free to let me know. I made this based off of the pattern that a Taiwanese doctor came up with and shared on Facebook. That is that's a style of mask that I'm going for. And to make this mask, you're gonna need some pre-wash cotton fabric. I wash and I iron all my fabric before I start. And you're gonna need to cut two pieces that are 8 inches by 14 inches. And also two pieces that are 2 inches by 4 inches. The 8 by 14 inches, your one's gonna be your top layer and inside layer. And the two that are the 2 by 4, those are your little air pieces for the sides of your mask where you're gonna attach your elastic through. Now, I've been doing this, I've made over 30 masks already for members of my family, like I said. And by the time I'm down here to 30, I can tell you now, I'm doing this pretty much assembly line style. I iron everything out and then just hit the sewing machine, and I don't even pin anymore. But it's really simple to do. What you're gonna need to do is you're gonna fold in hems on the top and the bottom and sew those down. And then you're also gonna go ahead and find center of your piece of fabric, and then you're gonna start making pleats. I make 3 pleats on the top side coming towards the bottom, and then I make 3 pleats on the bottom half going towards the top. Now here I'm pinning them in place, but like I said, at this point I no longer even pin them. I just use my iron to just give it a little extra press and some steam to make sure it stays in place, and then I just go straight to my sewing machine. And I do these in batches now, so I'm like literally making, you know, 6-7 at a time as I'm doing it. So here, as you can see, you have the basis of your mask. You're gonna now take the two little smaller pieces, you're gonna fold over and iron top and bottom. That is just so your raw edges are hidden over. And then you're gonna fold it over lengthwise to make a long loop, and that is gonna be going where your elastic or cording or ribbon, whatever you're gonna use, is gonna be threaded through on the outside to secure it. Now here I have everything pinned up, and basically all I do is I align my two air tabs equally on both sides and then pin that in place. Now, like I said, this is a video I made quite a while ago, but I've been doing this now so often that I don't even need to pin this anymore. I just go ahead and fold them up like that, iron it, press it really good, and then go to my sewing machine. And it's really simple to sew all the layers and all your pleats up together at the same time. However, if you're a beginner, you can certainly sew the pleats down first and then sew everything separately. So that's just to give you an idea of how you can do it. But now what I'm doing is I'm sewing the tops and the bottoms first, then I go to my ironing board, iron in my pleats, put in the little air piece, iron it into a straight little pouch, and then sew everything up together. So this is how I'm making my mask. I hope you guys like it. It's simple and easy. I know many people already have videos out there on how to do this. This is just my version and my take on this. And the key to my design, basically, it's all about the ironing. The ironing does all the work for you. And I love the fact that you can, you know, put your actual N95 if you're lucky enough to have an N95 mask. You can put it inside and extend the life of it, or you can put surgical mask inside. And all of my healthcare workers, they love this one because, like I said, it helps extend the life of their mask. And that's pretty much it. Please feel free to leave me any questions or comments if you have any and how to do this. I will be uploading a video tomorrow to share with you guys what I've been doing, what else I've been doing in my garden. Pretty much, like I said, I have not been in the mood to make videos since the world has turned upside down. I am just doing my crafting stuff to keep my mind occupied, and I've been spending an awful lot of time in my garden, which I will be sharing with you tomorrow. So thank you guys all for watching. Please don't forget to hit that like and that subscribe button. And I will see you again soon. Please be safe. Wash your hands. Assume that everyone is contagious and treat them that way so that you do not get sick. It's for the best of for everyone. We're all, you know, we're not all healthy, and we don't know who has deficiencies. So just look out for your fellow neighbors and your fellow human by doing all the necessary steps and taking all precautions. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.